like a box of chocolates, this actor's career has a little of everything, and you never know what you're gonna get. Welcome to WatchMojo.com, and today we're taking a look at the life and career of Tom Hanks.
I'm empowered to stand here thanks to the ensemble of actors, men and women, who I shared the screen with, who in ways that they will never understand, made me a better actor.
Born July 9, 1956 in Concord, California, Thomas Jeffrey Hanks studied theater in college, but left to move to New York City in the late 1970s. He quickly signed with his first agent after appearing in a theatrical production of The Mandrake. Hanks kicked off the 1980s in the role of Kip Wilson on the short-lived sitcom Bosom Buddies. This caught the attention of director Ron Howard, who cast Hanks as the lead in one of 1984's highest-grossing movies, the romantic comedy Splash. Hanks followed this up with movies like Bachelor Party and The Money Pit. The actor began showcasing his serious side in the 1986 film Nothing in Common. However, it was in 1988 that Hollywood really took notice of this young actor. The successful comedy Big told the tale of a teenage boy who wishes to be an adult, and Hanks' role in the film yielded his first Oscar nomination.
So what did it make you do for all this?
Well, I play with all of this stuff, and then I go in and I tell them what I think.
That's it?
Yeah.
And they pay you for that?
Yeah.
Suckers!
A string of commercial flops followed. However, Hanks found success opposite a lovable dog in the buddy cop comedy Turner and Hooch in 1989. 3 years later, he ruled the box office once again as the manager of an all-women's baseball team in A League of Their Own.
Which team do you play for?
Well, I'm a peach.
Well, I was just wondering, because I couldn't figure out why you would throw home when we've got a two-run lead!
In 1993, Hanks starred in one of the most popular romantic comedies ever made. He played a widower opposite Meg Ryan in Sleepless in Seattle. At the end of that year, Hanks showed off his dramatic skill once again as a homosexual lawyer with AIDS who is dismissed from his job in Philadelphia.
AIDS is protected as a handicap under law, not only because of the physical limitations it imposes, but because the prejudice surrounding AIDS exacts a social death which precedes the actual physical one.
Despite its controversial subject matter, the movie was a box office smash and won Hanks his first Academy Award. The following year, Hanks portrayed the title character in Forrest Gump. This successful drama chronicled important 20th century events through the eyes of this simple man and led to Hanks' second Oscar win.
I'm not a smart man, but I know what love is.
In 1995, Hanks played astronaut Jim Lovell in a film inspired by the 1970 American lunar mission, Apollo 13. Later that year, he brought the character of Woody the Cowboy Doll to life in the computer-animated film Toy Story. This successful movie spawned two sequels. In fact, 2010's Toy Story 3 was Hanks' highest-grossing film to that point.
Hey, who's got my hat?
Look, I'm Woody! Howdy, howdy, howdy.
Give me that.
In 1998, Hanks appeared in what was widely credited as one of the best war films ever made, Saving Private Ryan.
Covering fire!
He then reteamed with Meg Ryan in the romantic comedy You've Got Mail. The next year, Hanks acted in the Academy Award-nominated drama The Green Mile. He followed that up by befriending a volleyball in the critically acclaimed 2000 drama Castaway. In 2002, Hanks played a hitman in the period piece Road to Perdition. Catch Me If You Can was released a few months later and told the true story of con artist Frank Abagnale Jr.
What he's doing is he's opening checking accounts at various banks and then changing the Micker Inc. routing numbers at the bottom of those checks. Next slide, please.
2004 was another busy year for Hanks. He appeared in The Lady Killers, The Terminal, and The Polar Express, and that film showcased the actor in multiple roles.
Christmas may not be important to some people, but it is very important to the rest of us.
Hanks courted controversy in 2006 when he took the role of Robert Langdon in the film adaptation of the Dan Brown thriller, The Da Vinci Code. Despite criticism from the Roman Catholic Church, it was the year's second highest grossing movie. Its success paved the way for a sequel. In 2009, Hanks reprised the role in Angels and Demons. In 2007, Hanks portrayed an American congressman in the biographical drama Charlie Wilson's War. The next year, he starred as the father of his real-life son, Colin Hanks, in the movie The Great Buck Howard.
I want you to know you have raised a very, very fine young man who is doing a wonderful job for me.
I thought he was in law school.
Then, in 2011, Hanks played the title character in the drama Larry Crowne. Hanks has spent some of his career behind the camera as a director, producer, and writer. Thanks to his many talents, Tom Hanks has been involved in some of the most critically and commercially successful films of all time, and will surely go down in history as one of the greats.